Welcome back. And what is that you say? Yes, we're doing another of the same kit. Just because Revell sent two over. Now, a little while ago, I did one version of the 29 Model A Roadster, and you can check out that review on the channel. I did it with a white body and some aftermarket decals. This one we're going to build completely out of the box. It's their two-in-one kit, 149 parts in 1/25th scale. Let's take a look in case you haven't seen that review. We'll go through all the cool styrene in this kit again, and it's worth looking in case you don't remember from the last one. You have two interior options. High boy and chopped on this one, and they will tell you exactly what to use, which radiator lines to use, which firewall to use, depending on which version you're building. The manual lays it out nice and clear. But isn't that pretty with the seats in there? We got our steering components. A lot of the stuff stays the same between the two, but you can build one of two different engines for this beauty. This body will stay the same between the two. I love how everything's pre-drilled out for the little door handles, the tail lights, the license plate frame. It's all well thought out like you would expect from a modern kit. Here's the actual exhaust system. Let's get some more plastic out here. Two separate frames, yes. One regular, one chopped in there for you. Nice. I want to make sure that you have the parts you need. Obviously, this is a big parts box filler, because you're going to have a lot of stuff left over no matter which way you build it. We'll get the rest of the white styrene out here. We got other exhaust system. It'll depend on which frame you use and depending on how high the exhaust has to arc. We've got our V8 with transmission. Look at those beautiful cylinder heads on there. We got our intake, starter, belt system, two drive shafts, belt and pulley system for the blower, carburation on there. We've got our differential. Now, from previously building this, I didn't have any fit issues. Everything seemed to go together just fine. Awesome floor pan on there. We got our exhaust dumps. These are your options to come off the headers off the side, or you can leave them off and just have it dump onto the ground. We got our dashboard there. On this one, we've got our fuel tank, we've got our brake drums, we got our wheel backs, we got a set of steelies, nice wheels on there. So you can set this up in a couple different ways. On the other side of the desk, we've got our clear parts, three different headlight options. Save those for the part box. You can only use one. Nice little windshield there. Now check this out. One, two, three, four chrome trees. So much chrome. We got carburation. We got gorgeous exhaust headers. Check it out. They've got their dumps built into them to drop that exhaust down. Look at the finned valve covers, transmission pan, oil pan, pump cover, blower parts. Check that out with that blower scoop. Must be modern style molding, one piece blower scoop. Ooh, that is excellent for the parts box if you're not going to use it. We got our front suspension. We got trailing arms and links, all in beautiful chrome. Check out this radiator. Oh, so nice, and mold it in so that if you didn't want to black wash, that even looks great as it is, as an aluminum radiator. Nice thin windshield frame. The last one I built, the windshield just snapped right in. I expect it to be the same. These itty bitty pieces are your gauges and your door handles. Look how small they are, and they're still chromed and they're not all caked over. Another set of second wheels on there. These are the ones I used on the last build and painted over them. We'll see what I do this time. We got the knockoffs for those. We got trailing arms. We got two steering wheel options. We got our springs. We got wheel rings. We got Ford hubcaps. We've got all our headlight versions. Look at the different sizes of headlights on there. Three different sizes, all with the lens, anything you can think of. We're still not done with what's in the box. We got a sheet of decals. We got big and little tires. This one uses the metal pins for the axles, so I just wanted to toss those out there. These are some no-name black walls. They're beautiful tires. Obviously used them on the last build with some tire decals of my own, but this one we'll be building right out of the box. We got bigger rear tires. Now those for the detailers. Look at the tread pattern on that. Stupendous. Excellent detail. And the decal sheet, same decal sheet as the last one. Trying to pick it up here, come on. We got rust decals. We've got number decals for the doors. Rust decals, big V8 logos. We got our white letter tires if you choose to make them white letters. We even got an eyeball shifter and a standard 4-speed shifter. We got wear down on the seats. We've got door panels. All kinds of gauge clusters and callouts for the engine. Cutie little decals for the car, paso or bust. We got some nice scroll work on there. Excellent decal sheet that we'll be using, and of course license plates, skull and crossbones. A lot of extra details. I'm going to get everything assembled and I'll be right back. Since I built this kit before, building it the second time is even more fun, and it's even easier to get done. Of course, the more often you do something, the quicker it gets to do. Now I put the firewall in. I use the shorter firewall, and I'm using the chopped frame on this version. The last time, I think I used the regular frame on it. And so what I want to do is I want to build a little bit of a different version. On this engine, I'm going with the blown version. On the last version, I did the naturally aspirated 3-carburetor version. This one, I'm putting the blower on, and I'm also attaching some of the chrome parts right away that I don't want chrome, that I want to paint a different color, because you build each model for you and you decide whether you want something to be chrome or not. Something I do want to be chrome is that blower, and that is super glued together. Looks amazing. Needs no extra paint, needs no extra work. That is a beautiful assembly right there. Some of the chrome parts I plan on painting, I'm going to be using the big bug eye headlights. I like these extra big ones. And the aftermarket steering wheel instead of a more stock wheel, and the shift boot, I'm going to be painting those. Going to be painting up the steering link separately from the rest of the vehicle. On the dashboard, on the last one, I went with a metallic dashboard, then I attached the chrome. This one I'm doing a little different. I want to do it all as one unit, painted together, and then put the gauges in. On this one, I'm going to use the old Steelies. We got those all set up with their brake drums in the back and their metal rods. Now you can leave those if you want your car to roll, but I like mine to stay right where I put it, so I glued all that into place when I did it. I'll also be using different radiator than the other version that I used, so I've got that part cut free with the radiator hoses. I'm going to be using the shorter interior because I'm obviously doing the chop body or the chop frame, and it's going to sit lower. You have to use the shorter interior that we showed of the two, which means the other entire interior will be tossed in the parts box and used for later if we so desire. On this version, we need our belt and pulley system and our blower drive system and our carburetors, and this is the drive shaft you use for the chop chassis. So those are the ones that are all on one tree. We'll be able to get that all painted together, cut them free, and do our own detailing later on each part. It goes together super easy, super nice. Now on this one, I want my chassis and suspension all one color, except for, you can see I left the shocks and the trailing arms off. The back end there, I want to leave those the chrome that they are in the box, so we're going to go ahead and do that, but I will be painting the rear end. The front suspension goes together lovely. If you want to make sure you're getting it on straight, there is wiggle room in the front end to tilt it forward and back and left and right. So when you want to make sure you're going to be doing it correctly, all you need to do is just use a ruler, measure your distances, and then measure them in an X pattern. You'll make sure that you've got your tires all aimed in the same direction. Put the brake backs on there. Got our steering link in here glued in, and that can be adjusted as needed later if it's a little too far down. And I've got the pedals in, since the interior I'll be doing together. We got our whole front suspension, and that is a sharp looking assembly. These just go together so sweet, even though it's a lot of chrome. Everything is designed with little locator holes and everything, you know, even where this entire shock assembly fits in. And the headlight mount is that little rod on top of it. See that little pin on top? This could give you a lot of fits if they didn't have notches in the frame, if they didn't have super tiny holes molded into the chrome suspension. You could really have a fit with that if they had no locating marks, but luckily Revell has all the locating marks in there. And of course, the beautiful V8 will be dropping in right about that location there and looking nice. Now, when you decide to build it, make sure you pay attention. short firewall, long firewall, depending on A or B, which version you decide to build. Now, I'm building the engine from version A and everything else from version B. But you can see how they will instruct you to get everything in there, use the right length radiator hoses, so feel free to get those painted up or paint up all the radiator hoses. And if you decide to change radiators and chassis and engines, paint them all up and you can test fit which ones fit in there and get it fitted more carefully, quicker. And don't forget to put your little steering link in there, of course, and they will show you a lot of the stuff that coincides with both models, like the pedals and the shifters and stuff like that. So it is an easy build so far. I'm going to start throwing paint at everything. Come and check out the scheme I go with.
Thank you.
Work commencing on the kit. We're getting some stuff done. I've got the tires sanded. Remember my socket extension trick for that? Just put your tires over a socket, as a viewer once told me, and rub your sandpaper right down them, and you get nice scuffed tires. You can even do a little bit down the sidewall so they look more authentic. We got our awesome little headlights. See how that Mod Podge dries crystal clear? You can't even tell it's in there. We got our excellent little headlight assembly. We got our grill done, blacked out the grill, left the center more metallic. Did black wash it, but rubbed some of it out to just so we have it in the darker areas. Got our decals on the seats. They look great after that gloss coat. Just shined them up a very little bit, and then we got our decals on there. The wheel and tire package is ready to go. All I need to do now is put my trim rings in, put my hub caps on, and those wheels and tire package are all set once we push them together. Detailed the steering wheel and the shifter, and then black washed it so we can see those little grooves in the steering wheel, but I wanted that nice gloss black ring. Check out those headers. They look like they've been coated. You can still see the nice shadows between the pipes like you would on the real thing. And just like the box art head, we left that dump open as well. I just have to black out the very tips there, and that's all set to go. Got our glass glued in place, nice and clear. Looks excellent. Don't see any traces of real glue or anything around there because I use that Mod Podge. Got the dashboard done. Accentuated just the gauges. Did the bolt heads too, so we weren't just a complete black, and then put our decals on there. That looks lovely. So check this out. The huge blown V8. Good thing it doesn't have any sort of fenders or hood, because it would never fit. But just using different tones and metallic shades, painting like the starter black, the oil filter, the distributor on the back, but leaving it silver. We got all of that ready to go. Got our alternator on, got our belt and pulley system. Used a silver marker to accentuate the pulleys and blackwashed them a little bit so they weren't as stark. And that is one heck of a tall motor and nice looking. Excellent to use in numerous other kits, so go ahead and enjoy that. What I'll be doing now is assembling the interior, snapping the panels for the side. They actually snap inside the body. You don't build them around the chassis. They snap inside the body instead. We'll be getting the rest of the engine put together. We'll be getting the wheels and tire put together. We'll be using our chrome parts here, our trailing arms. I painted up the springs. After I washed them black, I painted them red, just for a little green and red accent underneath. You're not going to see a lot of it, but it'll be down there to see. We've got our metallic drive shaft. We've got a little cool accents parts that'll distract a little bit from the overall black, gloss black, and green scheme I'm going with. Check out when you do the light coat on the body. See how you get hints of, you definitely get your black panel lines, but you also get hints of black all through the paint. Then I hit it with a semi-gloss because I didn't want it super glossy like the gloss enamel was. I wanted it just knocked down just a little bit, and so that we get a lot of black shades. Now, if you wanted a solid green all the way around, just go with a heavier coat of paint so that you cover up all that black paint. You're still going to get your panel lines more than likely, but we're going to cover it up. But I'm kind of going for that, you know, guy that was in World War II 20 years later, modifying a Model A, and he still likes that green and black look of military vehicles, but he wants it to be streetable, so the body's kind of shiny, and it's got some accents and stuff, and it's pretty cool looking. So I will do a little bit more work. We'll come back to take a look. One last look before I button this whole build up, and again, it is building up nicely, and it's coming off pretty much the way I wanted. The green decals for the seat would have looked better with something built like the way they did it on the box, more of a tealish color. They're very light green once I finally had them together. What I did to tone them down, some Army Painter green tone, and I washed it over the seats to kind of tone them down, and the door panels to drop that green down. Next time I build one of these, and there'll probably be a third time because these kits are pretty darn cool, I will actually use the mask to paint the seats a green more similar to the body, and that will match it in. But they look pretty good, and with that wash, it helped a lot to tone those down. You can see we're getting it all together, and it looks awesome. I love that satin sheen. Now, not Martin sheen, satin sheen. I do plan on using some decals for one, that pirate motif in that off-white. You can see the white walls are white. The 78B and the pirate head are off-white. a darker, which is going to look beautiful on that body. I also want to use the Ford emblem. Where did it go? Oh, come on. It's right there. Yep. The little tiny Ford emblem for the grill, I want that on there. And then I'll decide whether I want the eyeball shifter or the standard four-speed shifter. And I'll pick out a license plate. I'm not going to use any of the rust decals. I didn't want this one to be any sort of weathered or rusty. I wanted it to look pretty darn nice. You know, aside from, you know, a little, these headers with that Ceram coating, they rarely stay bright white for very long. So, but otherwise, I wanted it to look pretty nice. I have to put the trim rings in. And I have to put the hubcaps on that you saw me wash earlier. I have to attach the headlamps. I'm glad I went with the big ones. That'll look better because they're more comparable in size to those hubcaps, and I kind of like matching that up. You get that feng shui. I got the door handles to put on. We got the glass to put on. The windshields on these, whoop. The windshields on these go pretty good. I think I can set it there. It might stay without gluing it. Nope. Well, anyways, it sits right up there. Like so. You've seen the other one. You'll see this one with the glass on it. So I'm just working on it. You can see we got our underbody done with those cool red springs. We've got all our metallic look, and doing it over the black roughly makes it look like more of a raw metal. Some advice, if you're going to do the chop down body and the channeled frame with the blown motor, you'll have to make some adjustments in your kit. You will have to use not the long drive shaft. You will have to adapt it and use the short drive shaft, but it fits right in, okay? Also, because the pulleys on the front of the engine stick way out on this version and the frame is a little different on this version, on the front cross member of the frame, the piece that goes across where normally your engine will drop down in front of it, you will have to take your hobby knife and shave off about 1/8 of an inch of a material. So if you have like a finger here, this part here and this part here, your engine normally mounts right to the front and your belt and pulley sits back here. When you do the blower engine on the chopped frame, you will need to just carve out a nice little cut. I did mine a square cut. You can kind of see it underneath a little bit. You really can't see it once it's assembled. That's the nice thing about it, but you'll need to cut that out. And that's very simple modifications to do. Otherwise, as you can see, she all lines up real nice. And you don't have to modify, you don't have to make your own drive shafts, you don't have to do anything like that. And you can get the big blown motor in the more chopped coupe, which is the look I wanted to go for in this build, because the last one I did the non-chopped frame and interior with the naturally aspirated engine, so I wanted to change it up for this one. He's a madman. You know, he's got the army, they love the army bombers. He's got the big motor in this thing, and he really wants to haul some ass, so you are going to be just fine and easily cut that plastic to fit that engine and get that pulley in and still get your radiator lines to fit and everything. It'll be just fine. So let me bolt everything up, get these decals on, give it one coat of future, which I know will just gloss up that semi-gloss just enough when I'm done. Get that over the grill, get it on the frame, get everything shined up a little bit more underneath, and then we will be back for that final. No matter which version you build, no matter which way you decide to take your models, you're going to end up with an awesome final product from Revell's 29 Model A in 1/25th scale. 2-in-1 kit. Now you've seen me build 2 different versions of the kit and how easily it is done. This one, you know what? Just because it's the most recent, that's not why. I think this one's my personal favorite of the two, just because it's got the big mean blower. I always like white ceramic coated headers. I like the black and green look. I just bought a brand new truck, a Toyota Tacoma TRD Pro, a 2020. They're limited edition in that army green, and I had to do one up with it with the black wheels, the black grill. That's pretty much what my truck looks like. And now I have this cool little Roadster that I would drive in real life, park it next to it in the garage. No matter which version you build, no matter which decals you use, you're still going to have a ton of decals left over for detailing your own version. You're going to have a complete set of extra wheels, steering wheel, 2 more sets of headlights, knockoffs, and all kinds of white styrene parts for your enjoyment. An easy build. Anyone can build these. If you've done a few model kits, you can easily do this model kit because it's a modern style and it goes together super easy. I thank Revell USA for sending over this copy, sending over both, so you get a chance to see 2 different versions, one with the high body, one with the low body over the frame, and see what that interior looks like with the differences. Now on mine, I went with the eyeball I decided. I did the green wash on the interior. I used the Misfits license plate. I used Tamiya Clear on those taillights. Had to use the skull and crossbones on this one. And the number plates. Now you can see on the box, they put them on the door. I wanted them back here on the back. I just like them back there more. It's just my preference. I used the trim rings and the hubcaps over those gloss black wheels. And I love it. Did the headlights in gloss black. Showed you how to use Silly Putty to mask those off. Did the grill in black and then glossed it. Left the radiator and the belts, the more flat black for realisticness, and black washed certain fins on the motor. And then, of course, we have underneath where she looks awesome. Did those red springs in the back. They really stick out from the back. And I just love how it turned out. She is a sweet model and an easy build. By the time this video comes out on Saturday morning for you to watch at 11 a.m. Central Time, these should be arriving at Model Roundup. There will be a link in the description to get your pre-order in if they're not in already when this video comes out, so that when these are back in stock, you can get these immediately. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review.